welcome. It's lovely to see that you are all appropriately social distanced. So thank you for that. What a world we are living in these days, hey? So reflective in the way that we're gathering together today. So on behalf of Captain Jackie Lang and the people of the King's Meadows Corps, I welcome you to this celebration this afternoon. A celebration that is going to honour 98 years of ministry. 98 years of men, women and children who have reached out into the neighbouring area of South Launceston and King's Meadows. What a privilege it is to be here today and to lead you in this service. Because today we stand on the legacy of those who have come before us. We stand on the legacy of the faithful men and women and children who have ministered so faithfully over these many years. Some greats in the faith, and I'm sure for each of you, you can think about those who have influenced your life and your community. So welcome to those of you who have travelled from near and far today. Welcome to those who are joining us on the live stream. I would like to acknowledge with deep respect the traditional elders and owners of the land on which we meet today, the Palawa people of Lutruwita, Tasmania. I pay my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging, and commit us as the Salvation Army to the ongoing work of reconciliation in this beautiful state. And I welcome, of course, our Sovereign God, who is here with us to share in our celebration today. So will you please join with me as we pray. Oh Lord, we know that you are already here among us. It is in you that we live and move and have our being. And so Lord, as we join together today to honour a 98-year legacy of ministry through South Launceston and King's Meadows Corps, Lord, we pray that you will just move among us freely. We declare right now that we are your people and that you are our God. And it's because of you that we are here. So, Lord, may our offering of praise be fragrant and sweet to you. And may our words bring praise and glory to your name as we share together, we pray, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. 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 Well, friends, I wonder if you would stand with us. We're going to share in a time of giving our praise and our worship to the Lord. And so, Bandmaster, I understand that we have an intro to our song today.
Just so you know what the tune is.
Just so we know what the tune is. And so we're going to sing today, Be Glad in the Lord and Rejoice.
Amen.
the Almighty, and I understand we're going to sing verses 1, 2, and 5.
Down and see you. everybody.
Shield a bit,
Elf. Yeah. Oh, what are you doing? What do you want?
Have you anything to donate towards the Red Shield, Rob?
Come to the Lord and He will give you rest.
Praise God, you need to come to the Lord.
a sinner. If so, you can meet me here afterwards.
Name will added to not only our role, but that of a heavenly role as well. We praise you that you will always be with this child, helping them to grow to be a good citizen and dutiful to his parents. Our prayer, Lord God, this day is that this child will grow strong in spirit, wise in his youth, and socially adept in maturity. Let him be an example to those around him. To you be glory for all of this. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. a serious part.
You are.
Yes, it's a bad spiritual meeting. And I want you to take note. Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. You'll find the Bible, that's the book under the seat.
Yes.
And it says, in the beginning. Well, it's important that we start off and play music. But music's a part of creation. It's the healing balm to a troubled spirit. As we play, let it be so that our love for the Lord is granted, that we may play in harmony.
Aye.
Harmony! Oh, goodness me. If you'd have been at Scottsdale in 1967, when I was there, it was not harmony, was it? Amen. Loving one another as true brothers and sisters, we give praise to God today and make a joyful noise to Him. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you to all our willing participants and even the impromptus from the audience. That was amazing. So I hope you went down memory lane there. I hope you had an opportunity to think, oh, I remember doing that, oh, I remember doing that, or I can remember when Mum and Dad did that, or otherwise. And also those little folks, there's nothing like the moment when something goes wrong. But we're salvos, we just keep going. Isn't that the spirit? Hallelujah. And we will keep going. We give praise to God today. We're going to now look at a video montage. We've seen the scenes from what people have done over the years. Now we're going to see the people. These are photos at random from all sorts of people and places, events, etc. Now I apologise to anybody who's going to see somebody who may have already passed away, and it might bring back those memories for a moment. But we love you. You're here with us. It's all good. So have a look at these photos as Michael gently sings in the background in Christ Alone. Thank you.
Of his
show to every photo. We'll probably be here until about knees. There we go. Some of the photos, some of the memories. How are you feeling? Emotional? Let's celebrate. These people have gone before us. They started the spiritual journey and we will continue it. You've all been given a small gift. It was on your seats when you arrived. You should all have received a little pen. And on it, it says, ongoing spiritual journey. We want you to take that with you. We want that to take you that with you. We have somebody who's going to share now about their spiritual journey. We have Steve and Linda Miller. Now, we chose them, or I chose them, we chose them somehow. Somebody did, we came up, because they represent this place. They represent some of the stuff that's happened. They had their, I won't say birth here, but I can say spiritual birth here, and it's been ongoing. So let's hear from them. Afternoon to celebrate 98 years of mission and ministry of the South Launceston King's Meadows Corps, a family-oriented working class corps. And while the closure of the corps today may be a bit sad for some of us, as we look back over 98 years, we have much to celebrate.
Hallelujah.
Much to remember, and so much to thank God for. And so celebrate we will. In January 1995, which seems such a long time ago now, Steve and I left the King's Meadows Corps to begin our journey as officers of the Salvation Army. And I remember our dear friend Dale Brown holding the flag on the wharf as the Able Tasman sailed out of Devonport, and again carrying it into the Melbourne Town Hall as we were commissioned as Salvation Army officers. We were so proud to be out of the King's Meadows Corps, Tasmania Division.
We are.
We are. And we are so thankful to have had many of the King's Meadows Corps folk travel to Melbourne for our commissioning to support us. And while it was God who called us into full-time ministry, it was the faithfulness, the prayers, the nurturing, the investment of time into our lives that assisted us on that journey to the training college.
I can see the old Galvin Street Hall. I can see this hall because it hasn't changed much since the 21st of November 1976. I think the curtains are changed. The carpet's faded like my hair and my fringe. But I want to share some names with you, and they're the people that not just invested in my life, but they're the people that have inspired me in their faith, so I'd like to think that I'm still reasonable at that these days. I think of a giant of a man and a giant of his faith, a fellow by the name of Abel Reeve. And Abel Reeve used to say quite often, you should not be merely standing on the premises, you should always be standing on the promises. I remember Gary and Joy Pitcher. Gary taught me in directory, and he taught me what it means to be justified, and I've never ever forgot that. Joy taught me and lots of others in Corps Cadets. Wouldn't have got through without them. I think of a magnificent old couple, Wally and Essie Fitzgerald, yes, and for their influence in my life. I give thanks to God today for an old fellow by the name of Arthur Drayton, who didn't get on with my dad, but got on very well with me.
Not many got on with your dad.
I remember an old fellow I used to play in the band with, his name was Mick Target, and I remember his beautiful wife that used to play the piano for years and years. And they're the saints of this corps. I remember a fellow by the name of John Stewart that saved my life in the early 90s. If you're here today, John, Thank you. I'd like to thank Alan Heels for getting me my first job at the Precision Tool Annex. I remember Ruth Stocks today, and I also remember her old EJ Holden, that twin tone brown thing that she said that God kept it running for many, many years. I believe that to be true.
And John Stewart.
I really need to remember Arthur and Heather Brown today. You know, Ark always made our banding very memorable and a whole lot of fun. And I think Heather taught every child in the whole district in Sunday school at some stage or another. I remember the day my old friend Jack Taylor, and Jack was a real source of encouragement to me. And so was an old fellow named Freddie West. You never forget these good people. I think of Bob Radford today. You know, I must be getting old. These people have been incredibly important in my life, and they've really fed my faith, especially in those early nurturing days. And I'm very, very grateful for that. I think about my dear old dad today, Bobby Miller. What a troublemaker he was. We've had some very aggressive people in our core over the years. We've never had anyone as difficult as my dad. But I think of this core, and I think that this was not just his spiritual home, but in lots of ways this was his home. We've been doing some family history into our family, and there were some tough things happening in our family if you go back 3 or 4 generations, and you can see that how it affected my grandparents, how it affected the relationship they had with their son, my father. My grandparents didn't really get on along with Bobby, and Bobby didn't really get along with them. And so he found a home here among people that loved him and accepted him. And he also found Jesus. But he found something. He really felt like he belonged here. And I'm grateful for that today. Otherwise, I mightn't be here. I mean, that's no big deal, really. But I love the fact that my dad was so well cared for in a very, very difficult time in his life. And some of that trauma and some of that mental health still continues in our family, even with my brother and sister today. It's really sad what those sort of things do and what they do in families. But I want to thank God today for this court. I want to thank God for this band. Not just this one, but that one. I believe I was band saved for a long time in my life, but I'll talk a little bit about that later if my wife allows it. Yes, I should also mention, before I get too carried away, before our time's up, you know, there was people I loved to play in the band with because they're the people that really helped me as I was young. And I remember Bruce Stocks today. He was our best man in our wedding. You know, just a true Christian gentleman, probably not old enough to be a saint, he's probably working on him, but he was a great bloke, Bruce, and I'll never forget his influence in my life, his godly influence in my life. I want to remember my mate Dale Brown today. Sadly, Dale passed when we were both 38, back in 1998, and I miss Dale every day, like I miss my dear old dad. I've already talked about my dad, but he was a very important person in my life. Very interesting character, very open, very honest, and I rather liked
him. Well, there are so many beautiful memories that we have of this corps, and there are just too many to share in the 10 minutes, and I think you've already used up 11, in the 10 minutes that we've been given today. And I guess that you too would have your own memories. And I want to encourage you to hold on to those memories. Cherish them, as we always will. I remember going to a very young Kelly Walters, now Brown, to her home in Bladen Street and giving her timbrel lessons. And she was calling me Mrs. Miller, and I felt so old. But we had a lot of fun then, Kelly, and your friendship means a lot and still is very real today. I remember too when I was the youth group leader here, and I remember jamming just too many of our young youth groupers into our Bluebird station wagon, one on top of the other, to take them all home after youth group. Now, something that Work Health and Safety and Child Safety certainly would not allow today, and rightly so, but we had so much fun. I remember in the early 90s when Steve was unemployed and we were living on the unemployment benefit and trying to pay our mortgage up there in Gibson Street and feed three small children. And believe it or not, it was then that we truly learnt to tithe. We'd been salvos forever and part of many planned giving programs. But you know, it was when we were unemployed and when we had nothing that we realised just how faithful God is. When there was no food in the cupboard, no spare money in our pockets, we still tithed, trusting and believing God to provide. And although not knowing our situation, Sunday after Sunday, maybe Bunton would pass on cheese, biscuits and other food items to another corps member who would then pass them on to us. And we didn't know who it was who was being so generous to us. She wanted to remain anonymous. But how we thank God for her.
I mentioned John Stewart earlier, and John did an act for us that we'll never forget. And if it wasn't for John Stewart, we may not have had Christmas in 1992. Because John gave me a job that was sort of like Salvo's doors, cutting rags. And I'll never forget that time. I'll never forget that fellow's kindness. It's those blessings that we hang on to in tough times, and it's those things that we can always remember because God has proved faithful. I really need to be open and honest with you today. I was very happy to be band saved and just play my part, serve the Lord, thinking I was doing all the right things. And it wasn't till that same period in the early 90s that an officer that used to be good friends of mine asked me to think about taking on a leadership role within the Corps. And I wasn't a good enough person to take on that leadership role, and I had to do an awful lot of soul searching. I had to spend an awful lot of time at this place here, because I used to go let myself into the hall and spend a lot of time at the mercy seat of the holiness table to make sure if I was going to do this, I needed to be the right person to do it. And obviously I needed to rely on God to make sure I fulfilled that role. And so through the band, where God had held me in this holding pattern, he somehow got me to be the bandmaster, that bloke that waves your arm around in front of the bandsman. And that really changed my life. I think it was a real preparation of what we do now. You know, God prepares you a lot longer than what you ever think that he's preparing. It goes a lot further back than that. And it's something I'll always be grateful for. It actually changed my life. But it was ironic that he used something that was something that was wonderful to me, but he turned it into something that was even more precious. And a lot of those people that I've mentioned, we were part of that group, and it was such an incredible blessing. We were out of work. I was out of work. I was out of work for a couple of times in that early 90s, and John Stewart gave me a job. And before I could get a proper job, Linda actually got a job, and dear old Harry and Betty Green, we were doing it pretty tough, and they come up to us and bring some KFC, which was nice too. Kids love that. And I offered Linda a job, and you know, another thing, one of those real pivotal times in our life where life went in a different direction because God was leading us there. There's officers that we need to thank today. We need to thank Commissioners Brian and Caroline Morgan because they were just incredibly faith builders and faith setters. They just spoke God into your life. They were just amazing people. We really should thank Colonels Frank and Yvonne Daniels, because they were very instrumental in us going from South Launceston to King's Meadows. We need to thank Ian and Burley Hamilton, because we believe that they were probably ahead of their time, especially in ministry in the Salvation Army, and they took us to a brand new place in our corps, and they brought much growth and much renewal. And the mission statement that the corps leadership came up at that time under Ian Hamilton is still here with us today. We also need to thank the Callenders, don't we? They were good people. But there were some officers that were a part of this corps that weren't actually our corps officers, because we used to have officers up at Tyler House, and the influence that Alma and Ethel England had in our lives and in the life of our family. And Majors Jean and Alan Dale, they were just absolute unbelievable people. And they gave us the example of what it meant to serve God and people that are doing it tough. And hopefully we've learned something from that. Hopefully we are reasonable people. Hopefully we do have a good level of faith. And hopefully we will continue to serve God to the best of our ability because of what we have learned here and how we've been encouraged here and how we've been blessed here and how we've been nurtured in our faith. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, how we celebrate and thank God for the King's Meadows Corps, a place where our children and many others were dedicated to God, where we have said goodbye to people we have loved as they've been promoted to glory, a place where we have celebrated many marriages. And I think of the many, many people who have come to faith in Jesus over 98 years. I think of the hundreds, if not thousands, of people whose lives have been transformed through the ministry of this Corps. But I want to say to you this afternoon that this place, really it's just a building, it's just bricks and mortar. You and I are the Church of God.
Amen.
We are His hands and His feet. It's you and I who are to bring out the God flavours and the God colours in our community in which we live and work. The mission field, my friends, is not in here. It's out there. And even though this call will close today, we all can still represent Jesus wherever we are, wherever we go, and in whatever we do. So I say to you this afternoon, hold tight to the memories you have of the King's Meadows Corps and the people who have helped shape your life, and give thanks to God for the privilege of being part of its history. And I want to say this afternoon, King's Meadows Corps, how we thank God for you. We salute your faithfulness to this community and we say, well done, good and faithful servant. We're going to sing together. And I think we had a trial run a minute ago.
That's right.
Just seeing how the band are. And we're going to sing three verses of this song together. I believe it's verse 1, 3, and 5. Yes. Yes. So with the help of this illustrious band, listening for that tenor horn part, let's sing. Let's stand together. Let's sing.
Thank you.
and now, where I want to acknowledge in particular the children of this choir. We've had over the years, as mentioned and seen in photos and otherwise, a number of events that have taken place that involve children. As I said in the dedication of the baby that arrived miraculously during the service, it is a spiritual journey they take and it is a lifelong journey, and we've had an input into quite a number of them. We have some photos I'm going to show, but I'd like to call Zara and Harry out the front. I have a little presentation. At the start of this year, no, I should end with the end of last year, actually. Come on down, you two. At the end of last year, they actually finished the last of the books they were doing, which was the Gold Award for Zara and her sister Tiara. They did the gold, and Harry finished the silver. And in that, there was a mission objective that they had to reach a project, so they raised some money, and both of them gave some products to the local community. You'll see photos at the end of this video thing, photo collection. And they gave them to the kids here locally to help support them. So it's a pack of cards that you can identify with emotions and things. So they were specifically chosen by the kids and they were presented at the start of the year. So they have completed their awards, to which I have their certificates. But I'm also going to ask Roderick, where are you? As these children will not be able to come here to events anymore, we are now, in essence, moving them on to Launceston to continue the journey. So that's what will take place for them. So Roderick's just going to, if you don't mind, say a prayer for the kids and welcome them into Launceston, just as I hand them their certificates. I've got my glasses on, somebody will very proudly tell me they're on my head. So their certificates are here, and I just can't forget which is which. But you hold that one, and you hold that one because they look very similar, and you can hold the one for your sister as well. And we have. They're so little.
Heavenly Father, we just come with such grateful hearts. We know how precious young people are, how precious children are to you, how close they are to your heart. So we indeed want to give a great welcome to Zara, Tiara and Harry, and all who will join this work of the Salvation Army in Launceston. May we be good teachers, good instructors, and may we be wise in releasing them into mission. They're not our future, they are our now. All of us together are needed. So bless them greatly, Lord. We value them so much. Bless their families and continue to fill our hearts with joy as we learn about you and look to grow more like you each and every day. Amen.
I'm going to step up the notch here because now we will be spoken to by a commanding officer and our area officer, I can just do that, Captain Kim and Major Kevin, if I can call you by your first names, and invite you to the front now to talk about this ongoing spiritual journey for all of us. Well, thank you, Captain Jackie. Well, I have to say, friends, as the current Divisional Commander for Tasmania, I have been incredibly humbled as I've sat there today and watched all of your beautiful faces. As I've looked at the screen and seen the spiritual giants that have gone before in the 98 years of ministry of the South Launceston and King's Meadows Corps. And I love the way that this has been so beautifully displayed today in the skits. Jackie, I just want to commend you for the joy and the laughter and the happiness that was displayed The laughter was the key. The coercion that happened in order to get the actors for those particular parts. But what a wonderful way to speak about and to display and to show the incredible work of God in the lives of many people of this community. And as I was sitting at the back there, I was thinking, how many souls are in the kingdom of God today and into the future because of the men and the women and the children who have gone before? It's their legacy that we stand on today. And I am just so incredibly grateful. I just loved listening to the name, Stephen, that you gave during your time. And Linda, thank you for your testimony. And we are so grateful to God for both of you and for the work that you do in Tasmania. We're so grateful to Jackie and the way that she has led this corps over the last 5 years. And as we heard some of the names that were spoken, I am just incredibly humbled to think about the disciple-making that has taken place in this part of God's vineyard. Hallelujah. At the beginning of the journey of Australia One, a few years ago now, the then territorial commander, Commissioner Floyd Tidd, declared the words of Isaiah 43:19. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? Friends, these are challenging days, no doubt. But the Lord has placed before us a very clear clarion call to move with him into the new. Just over 2 years ago, the Lord gave me a vision for Tasmania. And it was a vision that I saw so clearly, a picture of the island that I could see and a wave that came from the northwest corner across the island diagonally. And as it came, I felt the Spirit of God say to me, this is my spirit and I'm going to bring renewal and revival to Tasmania. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And over the 2 years that I have been your divisional commander, the Lord has spoken very clearly to me about a call to be his Jubilee people, that we are to set ourselves aside with him. We are to seek him in repentance. We are to come aside with him and seek his priorities. Have a bit of a reset, if you like. Allow ourselves to come once again into alignment with him. Why? Because he is doing a new thing among us.
Yes, that's right.
And he is calling us to be people who bring freedom. John 10:10 says, if the Lord sets you free, you are
free indeed.
We are to be a people who bring freedom, first for ourselves and then for those that we are entrusted with, our community, the people who are out there, as Linda so beautifully said it. The Lord has given the Salvation Army a significant place in the body of Christ. We are to restore what has been corrupted. My friends, that is also another significant part of Jubilee. And our national vision statement says that wherever there is hardship or injustice, Salvos will live, love, and fight alongside others to transform Australia one life at a time with the love of Jesus. We celebrate today 98 years of doing just that. And while we can say, well, this is the end for the King's Meadows Corps, and we can be sad about that, and please do not let me take away the somber moment of that. I want to say to you that actually, every time in the kingdom of God that something dies, something new is born. Yes. Hallelujah. Death and resurrection. And that is the time that we find ourselves in now. And I want to say to you that the Lord has given us a clear pathway to spiritual renewal for Tasmania. He is on the move. I believe it with every fibre of my being. He is on the move. Next year, we are about to launch the East Coast Mission Initiative. God is on the move. We are replanting the Carlton Core into Sorrel. It's now going to take a regional approach and be the Southeast Selvos. We are beginning a new organic faith expression network strategy. Whew, that's a mouthful, isn't it? Around DHQ, we call it the Offie Network. The Offie Network. The Lord is asking us, He is imploring us to try new things, to set up a new strategy of organic faith expressions that will be complementary to our core. He is asking us to step out in faith in these days because He is doing a new thing. We've seen an expansion of social housing for the Salvation Army in Tasmania. In the last few months, we have won over $9 million in contracts with the government and with Salvation Army Housing to build 21 new housing units for Tasmania. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We have a crisis of housing in this state. We're going to be building 6 new family violence units on Creek Road down in the Lena Valley, and we have a vision to redevelop that whole property. We've also expanded our homelessness services to include 3 safe spaces. One that operates on site with the Bernie Corps and all the social programs that happen at Wilson Street. Another one that's happening in Launceston with City Mission, and also in Hobart with Hobart City Mission, the state government and the Salvation Army. My friends, I want to declare to you that we are going back to our roots.
Hallelujah.
That we are doing the work that we were raised up to do by the Holy Spirit. That we are going to find spiritual renewal as we submit and surrender ourselves to God, as we allow ourselves to be transformed by a move of God, as we say, yes, Lord, we don't want to build something for you, we want to build something with you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Last year, we opened up 2 new Salvo stores, or within the last year, and we have initiatives to strengthen Hobart, to strengthen Launceston, to work through greater collaboration for local mission delivery. My friends, our God is on the move.
Hallelujah.
He has not finished with us. He has not finished with the Salvation Army, and I am praying for greater things to come. What is the Lord asking of you in these days? Maybe He's asking you to lay down some things for the way things have always been and to step into all that He is doing. I would encourage you, if this is making your heart beat a bit faster, if you're excited by all that the Lord is doing, I want to say there are 530,000 souls on this island that need to know the love of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We have a great work to do. This is not the time to sit on our laurels. And so with that, I'm going to ask this bloke to get off his and to come and to share with us what's happening in Launceston. Bless you and thank you.
As Kim has shared of this vision that is for Tasmania around the island, speaking of the East Coast and the new thing in the Northwest and the strengthening Hobart, the things that are going to happen out at Sorrel as Carlton is relocated. There is this new thing of God that we are discovering, and it is happening right before us. And it's so for this north corner as well, here in the broader Launceston setting. It seems a little bit odd, doesn't it, that we're talking about growth when today the core comes to this closing chapter in its life. But if we take some steps back from that, it actually isn't closure. It may be around this thing called core and around the bricks and mortar. But there is a great work of God that is at hand.
Amen.
That is unfolding before us and is already at work right here amongst us, among many of you.
You know, it occurs to me as I look around the room and do some quick numbers of who's in the room. My estimation is that over half of you here today do not attend the core here, but once did. And you are taking the work of the kingdom and fulfilling it in other settings. Some of you as leaders, core leaders, leaders in all sorts of capacities and in other denominations, not just the Salvation Army. Many are active participants in other denominations and in other core all over this island. The King's Meadow core is living on in those things. Can you not see the good work that is being done? Did you not hear the testimony of Stephen and Linda? See, that it doesn't finish when the building doors are closed. What matters is what's carried on in the heart. And I'm going to invite you to open up your spirit to the Spirit of God for this new thing that the Lord seems to be doing. Seems to be unfolding before us, and we're on this journey of discovery. We have this initiative called the Strengthening Launceston Mission Initiative. Another big term. And we don't really know what it is. Other than we have sense that while things appear to be declining, the Lord wants otherwise. And the Lord is ushering otherwise, and it is happening. Even imperceptibly now, and in greater measuring times to come. And you and I can bring that forth in whatever way the Holy Spirit wants to lead us, if we're obedient to that. The King's Meadows call, the spirit of it, is called to live on as the Holy Spirit moves and prompts. This thing that I was talking about, called the Strengthening Launceston Mission Initiative, it's a simple concept. Believing that the Lord wants more.
Amen.
Believing that there is a new thing. We have to discover in these days what the new wine that the Lord wants in new wineskins, yes. What the new church might look like in a new way, whatever that is. And if we think we understand what that is, then we are mistaken. For the church has constantly, or consistently for a while now, or many settings of it at least, been in decline. If we knew what it was, we would have already been doing it. And so we turn to the Lord in these days, to what the Spirit is doing and bringing, and a new thing will come, a new wine. And new wineskins. And it's in us to help bring that into being. To be sensitive to the Spirit. To not give up as these doors close. But to carry on. As many have, over half of you, already in other settings. Does that make sense? Yeah. And so it's with excitement, really, of the things that are in front. For the kingdom of God and the good work in that is still at hand before us. It is ever as important as it ever was in the past. And in strengthening Launceston mission, we've been blessed in this thought that as this call comes to closure, it still has much to offer, even in the way of resources. And that there should be a consolidation of the resources here, wherever possible. From the band instruments to all sorts of other things that are material, but in the people as well. And normally when in the salvation, when a court comes to closure, that's it. It's over, Red Rover. There is no ongoing officer position. The doors are closed. Everything is swept. But we've got permission. We've been blessed that the core officer position here gets consolidated into the Launceston core at this stage. But you know, they've been in decline as well. And they need to be strengthened if we're to discover the new thing that is out in community so that we can create, you and I together create the new faith pathways for people out in community. Now, I'm so encouraged at the stories that I'm beginning to hear. God doing the new thing. Waverley community and the activity and community engagement out there that is taking place all by itself. And now in Invermark and Summerhill, possibilities of Youngtown, wherever the Spirit may lead, whatever that may look like, house church, the community of faith gathering, small or large, whatever it will be, yet to be discovered. But we can be the builders of that, the takers of that to being out there. Is that okay? I want to encourage you. Do not see today as a final thing, but as a quest to carry on the spiritual journey and take it to wherever the Lord is calling you. I pray for those that are part of the faith community here, still worshipping here up until this morning and today, this afternoon, that you'll be called and feel welcomed and wanted at the Launceston Core. But if you're being called to another faith community, that's okay. Just honour God in whatever, however God is prompting you. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Bless you.
Thank you, Kev. Well, I'd now like to invite Captain Jackie and Joy to present the King's Meadows Core flag to me as representative of the Tasmania Division. And we will take the flag to DHQ.
Sorry,
how
many stole our scissors?
Oh.
But Edwina's running. So
excellent.
But you can't find them.
Oh, we have. Beautiful. Thank goodness.
So friends, as the flag is removed from the flagpole for the last time, I just, in this silent moment, would you just offer up a prayer of thankfulness, a prayer of gratitude for all that has been. The closing of the King's Meadows Core and this part of the journey will never take away all that has happened in this place and all that has happened in this community. So let's honour it in a moment of silence as the flag is folded and presented to me.
Fire a volley.
Hallelujah.
I receive this flag in gratefulness to God.
Amen.
For all that it represents. 98 years of soul saving, of the proclamation of the gospel, of meeting human needs in Jesus' name without discrimination, of ministry and mission of the Salvation Army. Thank you, Lord. for every man, woman and child who has a stake in this flag and who is part of your great kingdom work. We are humbled. And Lord, we are so grateful that your work will continue. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Friends, I'm going to ask you to stand. In a moment, we're going to sing our last song. We'll go in the strength. Well, the song's called I'll Go in the Strength, but we'll go to collectively. But as you stand, I want to pronounce a blessing over you as we go out into the world that Christ calls us into to be his people out there among men. So please, allow me to pray for you and over you in Jesus' name. I echo in my prayer for each of you the words of the Apostle Paul and say, my response in awe and wonder of the new things, the ongoing spiritual journey that the Lord holds before us, is to get down on my knees before the Father, this magnificent Father who parcels out all heaven and earth. I ask him to strengthen you by his Spirit, not a brute strength, but a glorious inner strength, that Christ will live in you as you open the door and invite him in. I ask him that with both feet planted firmly on love, you'll be able to take in with all followers of Jesus the extravagant dimensions of Christ's love. Reach out and experience the breadth, test its legs, plumb the depths. Rise to the heights, live full lives, full in the fullness of God, my friends. In your ongoing spiritual journey, and as we go from this place, God can do anything, you know, far more than you could ever imagine or guess or request in your wildest dreams. He does it not by pushing us around, but by working within us. His Spirit deeply and gently within us. Glory to God in the church. Amen. Glory to God in the Messiah Jesus.
Amen.
Glory down all the generations to this day. And glory through all the millennia. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And amen.
Amen.
And amen. Let's sing.
I shake from the danger.
dinner, all right, which I'm sure will get your attention. I'm sure. You'll notice that your name tag tells you on the inside, if you're staying for dinner, one meal supply. You need to hand this in when you go and pick up your dinner. We can't fit everybody down the other end for dinner. There is memorabilia all over this building to look at. But there are some very clear signs about sanitising hands before you touch. Don't take things out of their pockets and leave the memorabilia where it stands. But you are welcome to wander through the building. Dinner will be served at 5. So there's plenty of time to say hello and chat to somebody before those that aren't staying for dinner do disappear. So enjoy yourselves in those moments. There is a couple of cold drinks. There will be tea and coffee as well. Anything else you need to know about dinner? Oh, you have to eat. You can eat throughout the whole building. There are some tables down the other end for those who need a table for stability. Other than that, you're welcome to eat in this room or the foyer, wherever you like. Dinner will be served. Three meats and a salad. No, it's three meats and three salads, four salads, I believe. And after all of that, when you're full of their sweets, we actually have a cake cutting ceremony. So that will be on as well. So if you want to stay for that, that will be down the other end. Thank you for that prompt. That's going on as well. Any questions about dinner? Any questions about anything else? Do remember the 1.5 metre thing and stay away from everybody, sanitise hands, you know. Do you all know where the toilets are? Do I have to do that one too?